So I think this is where we can start part two of the Siglent Spectrum Analyzer repair. So this is the HMC part that I believe is broken. And this is the stock number from RS where you can buy it. Now I will disassemble everything and put it on infrared with a temperature probe just between the glass and the PCB. And then I will use a magnifying glass here really, really good so I can see what I'm doing. And then I will use hot air. So hopefully I'll be able to place it really, really good. I see a little temperature challenge here. Look at this huge and heavy end connector mount. It uses two countersunk screws and M3 nuts on the back. So what I want to do is I want to heat up the here where we see the shiny light. This area I want to heat up just under soldering temperature and also way under the GG temperature for the FR4 or the PCB material. It's probably some Rogers or Nelco or some other sexy substrate, right? But anyway, it's going to be a big problem when this connector here is mounted. So either I remove it completely, this is just one little solder, or I just remove the screws and lift it up by some paper or something underneath. That is what I'm gonna do for starter and see if that's better. That was actually quite easy to remove. And look what they did. They actually milled a track in the metal so it can be placed directly on the RF track into the IC. So we're not going to change layers or anything. So the loss is going to be as little as possible and correct impedance all the way. Really clever design. We are ready to rock and roll. Heating up. See, I'm going to try and measure this input capacitor and let's see what we got. Ooh, 1000 nanofarad. It doesn't show here where I'm measuring. See, I am measuring the input capacitor. So it's about 1 microfarad. Interesting. Yeah, talk. We are now back home, power up, connected the through cable, preset. So that is a full sweep, tracking generator on, and this is minus 20. So all we have to do is, I think we just hit this one, right? And then dial it up, 5, 0. This ripple and this kind of stuff here, this is completely normal. This is really how it normally is, especially with this kind of thin, shitty cables. You need a really, really thick and short through cable, and then it will be a little bit less. You can see the different ranges of the different mixers and signal generators and stuff it is made of. And that is, like I said, completely normal. So I'm super happy it is back to normal and it works. Now I can assemble it and be happy, and I think I can afford a little takeout tonight.